finals, the Philadelphia 76ers have showed up for what they believe is rightfully theirs. Will they be able to break the stalemate and come out on top against the Bucks? Round 2 of the NBA playoffs continues, coming right up.
Game 3 of the Eastern Conference, the first choice, but who will get the advantage? It's the NBA playoffs on 2K Sports. I'm Kevin Harlan, along with Greg Anthony and Brent Barry, our terrific analysts, and kicking over to your sideline report. DA, take it away.
Well, thanks very much, guys. Of course, the NBA has had some legendary trash talk. But Damian Lillard says it's not really a verbal assault like it used to be. In this era, it's more gestures. Watch your head to too small, rock the baby. Trey Young's theatrical bows. Players have their ways of sending a message. Kevin?
And the message usually received, DA, thank you. Look at Philadelphia. This is their chance to get home court advantage, Greg, back after splitting the first two games.
And they can't wait around to do it. They need to take control of this series right now. As the higher seed, you can't let your opponent gain confidence early in the series.
Now look at Philadelphia's starting lineup. Front court is Thibault and Harris. Tyrese Maxey out there with Harden, and it's Embiid at the center position. Middleton, the small forward, with Dallas Antetokounmpo as the power forward. Hollyander with Gary Payton, the center. And Portis, with the center, filling out the middle. So here we go, the Bucks win the tip. Here's Middleton, and stolen by Feigl. Here's Maxey. Plays it off the rear to that field. Here's the other at the opening field to the center of the field.
Good job getting the ball and completing that play. Defense producing easy looks, it just helps you conserve some energy.
free throws, good for nothing. The 76ers have won 4-5 from the third quarter. And beat with a shoot on both of them.
Thank you.
Cheers. Pretty good. They bounce off the right side of the rim.
And the defense looks soft early on. They've got to sign up.
P.J. Tucker comes in for Matisse Thybulle. Thank you. That's his first opportunity. And had to take another pass with that
powerful rejection. And this is postseason play at its finest. Refusing to give up shots here in the playoffs.
Here's Connaughton.
To keep shooting if you're struggling this bad, a little bit of it. If he's going to keep shooting, they've got to run some plays for him. Screens, pick and rolls, anything they can do to get him started.
Top action. Okay, no good. So, no, I'm going to take it the other way. Let's take a look at the players who have pulled down the most rebounds during this postseason. second, Joel Embiid. Giannis Antetokounmpo, fourth.
Those two have been really aggressive in the paint so far this postseason. They provided the kind of rebounding you need in this atmosphere.
Screen cutting, Harden the best to Harris. And beating with a screen on Middleton. Then go on to the top. Shooting foul as the whistle blows for the certificate. Third pitcher.
Thank you.
Great to see the defensive people going strong inside. And Roger McGee has no choice.
Thank you.
2-2.
Thank you. Golden Sixers sense position.
You were close enough for next time. You might time that a little bit better and get a handle.
Two. There's Milton. There's Pillen. And this head time, we'll put him up. Thomas Adekunbo is feeling it tonight. Brooklyn's treatment for Milwaukee. His performance that quarter has earned him a double-double. Seems like he's been everywhere in this game. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks, guys. Here with Coach Budenholzer. Mike, your evaluation of the first half.
Well, I think both teams' defense is pretty good. You know, hopefully somebody can catch a rhythm here and score some points. You know, hopefully we can be better there.
Yeah, that'll be key as the game goes on, Coach. Thanks. Back to you.
All right, David, thank you. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the third quarter.
Greetings, one and all. The postseason drama we love, and no disappointment here as it's a close game so far for the Milwaukee Bucks.
Looking at their shot chart, they've made a clear effort to work things down low, doing a great job of getting points in the paint.
It's certainly playing to their strengths. They do a lot of damage around the rim. Seeing how things are shaking down for the Bucks, they were able to take a game on the road, capturing home court advantage. Shaq, how important is Game 3 for them?
Well, Game 3 is always huge. They took care of business on the road. Now they have to hit you guys with a big word. Now they have to capitalize on it.
Ooh. Well, it won't be easy, but I'm going to make a prediction, guys. You ready?
No, but go ahead.
Whoever wins this Game 3, they win the series.
That is bold, Kenny. I sort of like it. That was more than enough of us. Let's send you back to the game, Kevin Harlan and crew with the second half.
Good, and we'll do the kickback. over a minute and a half into the third quarter of action. And B with a screen on Hubbard. The three from Hubbard. They got the lead. The defense has 7 for 15 from the floor.
If the defense lets him, Hubbard will do this all night. Yeah, he will challenge his accuracy every time down the floor.
Now, here's Adebukumbo. He's got 23. Middleton with it. Just time in the clock. And now, Philadelphia in the break. First trip to the line
for Philadelphia. Matisse Thybulle. Two shots.
This is the truth.
Good for James Brown.
And Milwaukee calls their first timeout of the game. Thomas Antetokounmpo fourth.
And guys, that shooting percentage of his has been spectacular since the start of the playoffs. He has been completely locked in.
Giles Antetokounmpo is playing on the third floor. and he's good on the second. Bucks will be good. Bucks fast fighting. Bucks against Boston. Lindo is next to him. Portis has to get to Holiday. Portis the best to Holiday. Collington against Maxie. Six on the shot clock. That's passing it around. And here's Hendo. And Pirtle pulls it down. Pirtle's on the side. Milwaukee making a switch. The Buccaneers checked in. Then for the 76ers, P.J. Tucker comes in for Tobias Harris. And it should go in for James Harden. Turn over the screen on Collinson. Here's Johnson. Here's Pirtle. And he banks him a little. Pirtle's got six.
When Pirtle gets the rock deep inside, he is supposed to come around there.
Leading by five. Maxie passes to Pirtle. Passes to Milton. Here's Maxie. Trouble Covington. Maxie Milton. Philadelphia's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since starting off the break. Watson with it. Oh, man.
Oh, yes.
pulls it down. Kirby's got it.
And a chance right now to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery?
Yeah, those are the kind of plays that you want to put on a canvas. Just beautiful basketball.
Reeves got rebound number 13 from the Hurts and Allen. Harris passes to Embiid. Embiid up against the jump. Goes down. Embiid's got 4 points in the quarter.
Time out called the Bucks.
personal foul. Second team foul.
He doesn't hit the first, and that was the one they really want. He's got one more, though. There's 25 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
Great individual performance. I guess you're going for another MVP, huh?
Hey, you know, I try not to think about it that much. My mindset is do my job, do whatever it takes to help my team win, and all I get about is I've got to win.
Love the humble brag, man. Congrats on the win. Thanks.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. It's time for us to say so long. Welcome to the show that covered during the second round of the NBA Eastern Conference Playoffs. For Craig Berry, Greg Anthony, and Gilbert Ulmer, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. And now, we present the New Balance Player of the Game, Giannis Antetokounmpo.